involve ocean races for the best sailors in the world, period, regardless of gender. And I think we're in a position now where we can actually see the females coming back into the crews because they're rated professionals. I guess in my racing career, I've seen the women sort of get forced off the crews. And then obviously with what we did with SCA last time, come back into the race. And yeah, getting forced off the crews wasn't really a sexist thing. It was just purely power to weight ratio. You know, back in those days, a 105 kilo heifer lump like me, you'd get washed off the deck five times a watch. You know, and the boats was the sails weighed 130-140 kilos to get them up and down and throw them around. So there was just no place for anyone. You know, it was just total physique thing. But certainly in the last race, you know, the girls in Team SCA proved that, you know, there's a place for them in the race with an all-female team. But it's also, you know, we're going to get back to the days where, you know, females have their place within the crews and their own professional rights. So, you know, I think it's it is super exciting to see that we're evolving back towards that. So the combinations you can have at the moment is all male seven. You can go 7+1 or +2 females. You can go 5 and 5 mixed for 10. Or you can go 11 or female. So, you know, sailing these boats with 7 guys, there's just not enough sets of hands. You know, to race one of these boats, to give you an equivalent, you know, a 70-foot boat that you might race in the Maxi Worlds, you'll have 18 crew on board. So you do the numbers, you do the math on the number of hands on board, you know. So it's a tough decision. It's very tactical, but you don't have to stick with that combination either. You know, you could go all male for some legs, and then you could bolster the numbers and for other legs. So you might use a different combination, but as you can see, it's a very tactical decision as to whether you go with a 7 or you go +1 or +2, depending on the weight and the nature of the leg. So you know, it actually makes selecting your crew for the race, and if you're going to run a rotation, it gives you quite a lot of tactical options as to how to manage your resources throughout the race. We're not doing this as a race to tick boxes or to align ourselves with something in particular or get a headline. You know, we're doing it for building the future of the sport. Now, one of the biggest problems we had when we put Team SCA together was there was no females out there with experience to choose from. It was very limited. So now there's already that base of 14 women out there that were exposed to the race, plus all the others that we trained up. That have been, you know, have been a part of this race, and they could form the basis of the next generation, which is this race. And if we can multiply that by another 40 in this race, then people are, you know, they've been given the opportunity to become good enough to race around the world and learn from the best. You know, that's the other thing, is that, you know, if you want to become a fantastic Southern Ocean helmsman, well, you want to be standing next to Neil McDonald, and he'll show you how it's done. And that's who the likes of myself learned off. But for the girls, they haven't really had that opportunity. So, you know, and under race conditions, it's one thing training, but being out and racing in the Volvo race is a completely different thing. So to get exposed to that and be able to understand that that's racing and it's up here, it's a wonderful opportunity. So we need to build that base. So that's what we're doing.